This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to perform variance analysis if we're using an activity-based costing system rather than a traditional costing system. So we're really looking at activity-based costing. It's important to realize that we're focusing here on variable manufacturing overhead costs. So in a traditional costing system, typically we would be allocating variable manufacturing overhead costs using one allocation base, and commonly that allocation base is direct labor hours or machine hours. There are others as well, but those are the two most common that are used out there. That's traditional costing. So now we're talking about activity-based costing. What if we need to perform variance analysis in a system that uses activity-based costing? Well, it's similar for both approaches, but we're really, instead of just looking at one allocation base, looking at many allocation bases in an activity-based costing system, and we're analyzing the variances for each of those allocation bases that we are using. So activity-based costing, second bullet point here, requires calculating, in the variance analysis part of this, a spending and efficiency variance for each activity, as I just mentioned, rather than just one activity. So we'll look at an example of this on the next slide. The first thing that you should notice here in this variance analysis using activity-based costing is that it is very similar to looking at the variable manufacturing overhead variances using one allocation base. So instead of these three different types of activities, the purchase orders, product testing, and energy, we would just have one. And I have a separate lecture that has been created related to that scenario, that traditional costing scenario, and it might be helpful to take a look at that first before looking at this, because this is really just an extension of that approach. So what you see here, going from left to right, is the actual variable overhead costs in the left column, and we have three different activities: purchase orders, product testing, and energy. And then over in the far right, you'll see the flexible budget. And that's what we expected to spend in each of these areas. And then from there, we're going to try to figure out why we have a difference between the actual overhead cost, variable overhead cost, and the expected variable overhead cost. And we have two different variances that will help us to kind of describe why we have that, or understand at least, why we have that difference. We have the spending variance and the efficiency variance. And you're going to see that for each of these activities. So we'll just take a look at one of these, the purchase orders, and you can work your way through the rest and look at the footnotes carefully on your own as needed. But let's look at the purchase order piece of this. So the actual costs for the purchase orders totaled $42,000. And you'll notice that the flexible budget indicates that we expected to see costs of $52,500 because, or I should say, based on the actual level of sales that we had. So we expected, given the actual level of sales and production, to use 2,100 purchase orders. And again, you can look at the footnote down at the bottom to see where that comes from. That's the standard quantity of purchase orders per unit times the number of units actually produced. So we expected to see 2,100 purchase orders be used, and in fact we used, in the middle column here, the actual quantity of 1,600 orders. And the standard rate for each order is the same for both of these columns, the $25 per order for each of these. And therefore, we actually issued less purchase orders than we expected to issue. And as a result, we had, right here, a favorable efficiency variance of $12,500. Then we move our way over to the left, and you'll notice that we expected to spend $40,000 given the actual number of purchase orders issued, 1,600 times the standard rate of $25 per order. We expected to spend $40,000 on these purchase orders. And remember, this is our purchasing department and all the costs that go into making those purchase orders. Then we compare that $40,000, our expected cost given the actual number of orders, to the actual cost of $42,000, and you'll see we have an unfavorable variance for the difference, and that's $2,000. So this explains why we have Actual cost of $42,000 and expected cost of $52,500. This explains why the difference, partly because it's favorable overall because we had $42,000 in actual costs. We expected $52,500 in our flexible budget in costs. So this explains why we have the difference. We had a $12,500 favorable efficiency variance. We issued fewer orders than expected. So that explains most of that difference, but we had an unfavorable spending variance as well, and that offset that $12,500 by $2,000, and that nets out to $10,500, and that's the difference between this number up here and this number over here. So this is how we, and you can do the same for the next two activities, but this is how we perform variance analysis using activity-based costing.